Alrighty, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to another video. Today we have our five champs and we're going to be having them on no leans and no sprinting, and they're going to be up against five gold today. So wish them the best of luck. Make sure you guys follow all of the champs. Their links will be down below in the description. But all that being said, let's hop straight into round number one here. Yo, by the way, if you guys want to record in these videos with me, consider joining my Discord. If you're watching on YouTube, the link will be down below in the description. Or if you're watching on Twitch, the link is in the chat, !Discord. I record all these videos with viewers. So if you ever were thinking to yourself, oh, I could play better in this video than these guys, then, well, come do it. All right, look at our champ players walking around. No leans, no sprints right now. Honestly, the gold players look more like champs than the actual champ players do with just how bot like this movement looks like. But listen, the champs got to do what they got to do. Looks like we're gonna have Kilo in here trying to hold down Trophy along with True Craze at the moment. They're gonna be trying to stop this push in from Master side right now, but Leo is not going to be stopped. He's gonna walk in along with Proxy right now, who's gonna take a little bit of damage from the Fenrir. That's True Craze inside of Trophy. He's trying to swing, but he can't lean, so he's gonna be taking a huge amount of damage there. Kilo actually close on the breach with the shotgun. What is he doing? He just totally threw that right there. Leo will take him out, but Phantom with that immediate refrag onto Bagel. So the knock player goes down, C4 into the closet. Will do a little bit of damage onto Leo, but not enough to kill him. And Leo will grab that kill as Proxy grabs another onto Phantom. So the champ players are falling. KTT on very low HP as someone's flanking him downstairs. But True Craze alone on site grabs one, but he instantly gets refragged by Proxy. And now it's KTT versus three gold players here. He's on one HP, stuck in the basement, and he's got AJ on the jackal right now trying to hunt him down. Look at the angles the gold players are pulling out, just trying to find KTT right now. He knows the round is lost. He's just going to be inside a basement trying to bait for some kills. But bro, look at the patience on these gold players right now. They're actually holding. Look at this angle here from Ash. This is absolutely insane to be doing. KTT going to take himself out, not allowing the golds to take him alive. Smart move, bro. Smart move. Damn, no leans or sprints. That's tough. They have great game sense, but damn, they're basically T-hunt bots. Facts, bro. Facts. It's gonna be interesting. Looks like Kilo's gonna try to go for a spawn peek on the bottom white window. We'll see if this is gonna work for him. No leans, trying to do a spawn peek out through a window. I want to see if he's gonna get a frag here. It looks like Fuse is just fully sprinting out of spawn here for the most part. He might actually be able to grab this kill onto the Fuse player. We'll see. We'll see what happens here. Phantom all the way in the basement right now. Not even really sure what he's doing. Trying to deny a push in from Bunker, I suppose. But look at the operators coming out from the gold players here. They're going to be running the Blitz Shield as well as Ying right now. So definitely a lot of rush potential coming out from the gold players. And they're going to be using that to try to rush downstairs and roam clear. I think they're trying to see if KTT is downstairs like he was in the previous round, but he's upstairs, and this time he's going to be doing a lot of damage onto Wolfkin. But here comes the blitz. He's going to get flashed by his teammate, and KTT will down him, but Wolfkin's actually able to get the knife kill onto him somehow. But Kilo getting a kill of his own onto Proxy. The lion player goes down. Bagel able to get revived, so he's going to be put onto 20 HP, but somehow is still up. But as I say that, Phantom all the way from Big Tower is going to take him out. AJ going to be trying to fuse Master, almost taking out Leo inside of the closet. Questionable decision making here, but Kilo downstairs on the pulse, trying to possibly pull off a flank right now. Wolfgang gonna get taken out inside a meeting hall as Phantom is there to finish him off now. And it's gonna be up to AJ and Leo, our last two gold players. AJ gonna pick up one kill here. He's going for the second as Kilo is downstairs in classroom. The C4 comes out, but it's going to miss. And the swing from Kilo will take Fuse out. And now it's all up to Leo upstairs inside of Master right now. He is gonna have to deal with Soapy swinging Trophy. And finally, our champ's gonna pick up their first rounds here. You would think that the golds are gonna pull out like a quick 4-0 here against champs who just can't lean or sprint, but I don't know. The golds, they don't have the best decision making, right? Like even if they have the aim, like I don't think it matters because they just don't have the decision making that the champs do. Like we saw last round, like I don't know what Wolfkin or whoever the blitz player was last round, I don't know what they were thinking, because Ying Candela'd Armory and then blitz ran in as the Candelas were going off and got flashed, and he got put to 20 HP because of that, which eventually got him killed. So little things like that in like the gold players just, you know, play style that the champs are able to take advantage of and just win some rounds, I guess. All right, this is interesting. We're going to have KTT, no leans, no sprints, but he's going to pull out the Bashi. Now, that's questionable. And not only is he going to pull out the Bashi, but with the ACOG, of course, because how are you going to play the Bashi without the ACOG? But we are going to have the Golds playing some rush operators again. We're going to see Wolfgang on the Blitz right now, possibly trying to push through Garage. But right now, we really don't have like a unified push going on from the Golds. Leo going to take a lot of damage as he's trying to solo push into Bunker. And True Craze on the Fenrir is going to use that gadget to try to hold down Bunker solo right now, as it looks like no one's really helping him. Again, all of the Gold players really spread out through the map playing solo. AJ trying to push the main stairs, but he's got to be careful as Kilo is right here on the split door. But AJ does not care. He's going to walk straight down into sight. Now worrying about his flank a little bit, and it's good timing as Kilo is starting to flank. But no leans is going to make Kilo be put in a bad position here, and the swing just not going to work out for him. AJ wins that. True Craze getting a kill as well, though, onto Leo. And oh no, KTT grabbing a kill onto the Blitz player. Wolfen goes down. True Craze getting another kill as well. And AJ going down as well. A lot of kills happening off camera here, but Bagel, the last remaining Gold player, trying to push it through Z. He's going to run into KTT with the Bashi here in Z Hall. KTT trying to line up this angle. No leans, making it where he's swinging very wide on all of these angles. But here comes the swing from the ace player and the one tap from KTT and the Bashi. The champs win round number two. And honestly, that's a pretty good split there for the champ players. I'm interested to see what's going to happen on attack, though. You'll notice all the champs rushed over to defense when I started the lobby. That's because they really want a defense. Defense is easy, but attack is where things are going to get hard. You guys think not leaning is difficult, but when you can't sprint and you're starting on attack and you have to walk out from spawn with little cover, try to dodge spawn peaks, and you can't sprint, you can't lean to get a better angle on the spawn peaker, it's going to be difficult. So we'll see what happens. All right, here we go. The first attack round for the champs, you cannot lean or sprint. You can see the spawn peaks are already coming out here from the Gold players. So far, they've not been able to find a kill. I think Leo was the only one spawn peeking, but all of the champs doing the walk of shame, no sprint, trying to just push up to the building. And I don't even think they can. Oh, wow. You can actually walk onto the balcony. I didn't know that. Cray is going to be trying to push through the master balcony right now. Looks like that attic wall is soft. No head holes in it or whatsoever. Not even sure what's going on with that. True Cray is going to be doing a lot of damage onto this Mozzie, but he just can't finish him off. Leo trying to continue re-picking this. Why? He's on such low HP. Two of the champs outside of the master doors, Soapy as well as True Craze now, but Proxy gonna grab the first kill of the round on the Phantom, so Iana goes down. AJ gonna be taking a huge amount of damage now on the top of the trophy stairs, but here come the Candelas from True Craze, and they're gonna be pushing into trophy now, or master, excuse me, but True Craze gets wall banged after downing the Tachanka inside of attic. Now Bagel stuck inside of armory as the Blitz player from KTT is going to be on the top of the stairs, and here comes the ADS. KTT, how does he get away with it? But off screen, Tachanka is going to get revived, so he's put onto about 20 HP now, desperately trying to shoot off some fire and buy his team some time. But Leo going to buy his team some time with that kill onto Soapy, the Heartbreach player for the champs, going down. And now it's just left to KTT and Kilo. Can they pull this off? A minute and 20 seconds left. Two of the Gold players are extremely lit on about 20 HP. So this is very doable. And KTT is going to grab the first kill. Proxy goes down here. Now Kilo rotating up the white stairs. KTT doing a great job of distracting. And well, we see that with Kilo getting that kill into Wolfgang. He's going to be pushing into bunks now. But Leo off camera getting the kill into KTT. So a 1v1 situation now. Leo does not have the HP advantage, but he does have the leans and sprints, but it won't matter. Kilo takes him out, and the champs now winning 3-2-1. All right, look at this. KTT doing the walk of shame up to the building. It's kind of weird seeing Blitz just with his shield out, not sprinting at all, but a spawn peek here from Proxy. I'm not sure if that's going to work out for him. He tries throwing the C4 out the window, and wow, almost actually does a little bit of damage onto KTT, but he's able to pull away from that in time. And here comes a big rush from the champs inside of bunker right now. They're just bum rushing it, and True Cray is going to pick up the first kill here onto Wolfgang, and he's going for his second, but the Doc player is able to at least down him now. But Leo on about 1 HP going to heal himself back up. Kilo rotating in, trying to take this angle instead of True Craze as he's got the HP advantage. Soapy pushing in through pillar right now will grab a kill onto Leo, so the Doc goes down. KTT is above right now, trying to defend against this flank from Proxy. A lot of damage onto both players being done, but KTT with the ADS will do a ton of damage onto him, and Phantom with the push up onto the hallway will take Proxy out. Soapy with another kill. He's going to go down though as Bagel picks him up. The last player for the golds. It's match point. Can he win it? He can't. Kilo's going to swing, and the champs absolutely destroy the gold players. Wolfgang below inside of supply trying to do this classic C4. We'll see if it's going to work for him, but oh no, Kilo going to grab the first kill of the round onto Leo. So the Oryx goes down. Soapy going to be taking about half of his HP from one of those spawn peaks though. I think that was probably Leo who damaged him, but here we go. Wolfgang below with the C4. He's going to throw it out, and wow, he actually hits True Craze with it. We're just going to watch True Craze get completely blown up through the floor. Unfortunate for him. KTT droning outside of archives right now. I actually love this. He's going to be trying to get a wall bang or a kill here through the archives door. He's droning out. He sees where the clash is, and clash drops the shield, but oh no. How is KTT alive? Bagel misses the shots. KTT left on about 1 HP. Phantom going to get a kill off screen. That's the Ash player taking out AJ. So no more cav for the golds. Now Proxy going to be trying to defend against this armory push. Shooting that lion, stopping Kilo from pushing in any further right now. Phantom pushing in through office, taking a little bit of damage from the clash, who's trying to stop him from pushing in, but the Goyo inside a fountain going to go off, and that'll stop Bagel from pushing up and defending against this office take, allowing Phantom to push in now to office. Taking a look at KTT, he's repelled on the armory window, and he's looking like he might get a kill here soon, but unfortunately for him, it looks like the Goyo dropped. Soapy gonna grab a kill onto Wolfkin, so no more Capkin. Proxy goes down as well. KTT picks that kill up on the sandwich window, and he's gonna rappel straight into sight right now. Bagel, the last remaining gold player, will get taken out as Soapy swings in from metal. And wow, what an eventful round there. Honestly, I thought the golds were gonna win it. They got the first, or they got the second pick there. I thought they were gonna grab that kill into KTT, make things a 4v3. I don't know what happened, but KTT got away. I think he ended up grabbing one kill there. Yeah, that was not good for the golds. All right. Wow, AJ is going to start us off with a spawn peek. What did I tell you guys about these spawn peaks? It's going to be difficult for the champs to escape them. They're just not able to run away from the spawn peaks. And this Mira was unexpected there for the champs. And AJ is able to pick up one kill into True Craze, who's not having the best game here. But Soapy actually just going to jump straight in to the site right now, in through tellers and kill the pulse who's playing below. AJ trying to rotate up through the metal stairs, going to take a huge amount of damage now, as it looks like KTT has taken below along with the rest of his team now. AJ trying to hold the top of metal, going to do a little bit of damage onto KTT, bringing him down to about 30 HP, but Phantom off screen will grab that kill onto Bagel. So Mute player goes down, no more C4 there for him, but wow, a grenade from Soapy from below will take out Leo, and Kilo with that DMR is going to grab a kill of his own now. So one gold left versus four champs. Not looking good for the golds whatsoever, but Proxy going to be trying to do his best here, rotating up through 90. He catches one player off guard. Kilo goes down, but Phantom going to be rotating up the metal stairs, trying to get a refrag here. KTT inside of Fountain with Soapy will take down Proxy. Two rounds now to the champs. I really thought that the spawn peaks were going to be a little bit more significant. I feel like the golds just aren't spawn peaking enough. I don't think they realize how like crazy the spawn peaks are going to be. AJ was the only one to spawn peek that round, and he almost got two kills off of it. All right, Phantom is going to go down as AJ on the spawn peak. Look, AJ realizes how important the spawn peaks are going to be against these champs. It's just so much harder to defend against the spawn peaks when you can't lean. It's so much harder to grab some of these angles to counter the spawn peaks when you just can't lean to get that perfect, precise angle. You end up exposing so much more of your body than you normally would, and you can't sprint away from them either. So AJ looks like the only gold player who's going to be taking advantage of that, but Wolfgang going to be grabbing a kill for the golds as well. So now it's going to be a 5v3. The champs, for the first time here on Border, are looking like they might potentially lose a round here. True Cray is going to be sending out a call, trying to push down below in customs right now. Proxy going to get killed as KTT swings the armory door, and he's going to be trying to push in through armory right now. True Cray all the way downstairs will grab a kill onto Bagel, who was below, but he's gonna have to be careful as there is a player playing on the top of metal stairs right now. That'll be AJ, who's playing inside of 90 at the moment. Soapy trying to push in through armory doors along with KTT, but It's just not looking good as Wolf is sitting here denying the push in. AJ going to still be over by office right now. Wolfgang with his second kill in the round. Soapy goes down. It's all up to KTT and True Craze, who are not together right now, but KTT able to open up that angle through the wall, take out Wolfgang. Now it's a 2v2. Craze rotating up through the metal stairs, trying to see if he can grab his sneaky kill here, but Leo is going to be on site just behind the armory lockers, trying to hold the push in here through metal. AJ inside of fountain or office, trying to deny this push in here, and it looks like our champs are not really pushing together, and that could be the downfall here. If Craze decides to push without KTT, it's not going to be good, as if Craze falls, KTT is going to have to 1v2. The smoke grenades come out from KTT, and he's going to be trying to push onto this balcony, potentially trying to take out AJ on the pulse on the office door. Craze throwing out an EMP grenade, trying to distract Leo possibly, but here we go. True Craze pushing in through metal stairs now. KTT not with him, but AJ is going to be down. KTT was able to down him off camera, and now Leo will grab the first kill to True Craze. He's got this first kill of the 1v2. AJ goes down as KTT will finish that kill off, but the wallbang from KTT will take him out, and great clutch from KTT on that round. The champs now leading 3-0. How do you enter in these videos? Join my Discord server, bro. If you're watching on YouTube, the link is in the description. If you're watching on Twitch, !Discord, it's free. Consider joining. I just add the server and I say, I need this rank, I need that rank. And if you're that rank, then you can play. All right, Craze setting up some Fenrir gadgets outside of security right now, trying to defend against any of the gold players pushing up through the CCTV hall outside there. Leo gonna be taking a little bit of damage. I think he got shot by Wolfgang, who was trying to shoot that default cam. But oh no, here come the Candelas, the Fenrirs as well. True Craze grabs one, Leo goes down. The procs, the Candelas are flashing everyone from proxy right now. KTT going to impact his way out of detention and pick up that kill into Wolfgang. The Jackal player goes down. Proxy with the diffuser now, going to be trying to rush in through East Stairs, but there is going to be a player inside of Break Room he's going to have to be worried about. That's going to be Kilo. Phantom's going to go down though, as AJ on 1 HP after that engagement will take him out, and Soapy with the refrag, the Deagle of all things, is there to take him out. That's actually insane. It's all left to Bagel and Proxy now, and Proxy will grab the first kill here of this 2v4. 2v3 now. Here comes Soapy inside a Break Room. He's trying to get this refrag. He's going to take a little bit of damage here through the wall. KTT is pulling up as well. He's going to almost impact himself though. Impact will miss. And looks like Bagel has shown up as well. True Cray is going to grab the kill on the proxy. So it's all left to Bagel in this 1v3 clutch. KTT is actually fairly lit. He should be one shot for the 552 commando. So this actually is fairly winnable here for Bagel. Take a look at the scoreboard though. He's 0-3, so he's gonna have to get 3 straight kills here if he wants to win this here. Looks like he's confused on what he even wants to do. The champs desperately trying to find exactly where he is, but they can't sprint around to find him, so it's gonna be a slow process. But oh no, Bagel inside of Teller's window actually going to take most of his HP, as it looks like he wasn't able to get any shots onto the champ players with only 50 seconds left. If you notice, none of the champs are actually on site right now, but Bagel doesn't even have the diffuser, and a Fenrir all the way outside in spawn will spot him out. This is unbelievable for the gold player. What do you even do if you're in his situation here? All right, here we go. Craze is going to vault over now, trying to grab the kill, and he actually does the hip fire across the way. Bagel will trade him out as well. That was an interesting gunfight there, but GG's. I guess the golds are not capable of beating the champs even without sprints and leans. But thank you guys for watching. Make sure you guys are subscribed, turn notifications on, like the video. Make sure you guys follow the champs with the links down below in the description, and I will see you guys in tomorrow's video.